Hey, what's up, everybody? So, this is a tribute, man. A tribute reaction to a great, great legend of music. Not just country music, her respective genre, but she has been an influence to pretty much everybody who has been living and breathing over the last, I'd say about 80 years, something in that fashion. I heard that Loretta Lynn passed a couple of days ago, and it's only now that I'm getting a chance to get this reaction out to you, so apologies for the lateness. I took the morning off to do this. So, man, first off, I just want to give a shout out and a thanks very much to one of my, probably one of my very first subscribers, patron, supporter. He's been around for a long time, Jeff. Jeff has a note for us. He said, Wayne, my favorite lady singer has died, Loretta Lynn. Here are two links. I've chosen these two songs because a number of reactors have used them without getting blocked. Fingers crossed you'll be lucky as well. I'll be under for a while, so I won't be around to see your tribute, but I know it'll be good. See you in 6 months, Jeff. Jeff is a submariner, and when he goes on deployment, which is two, sometimes three times a year, he's gone for a long time. So I only hear from him once in a blue moon. So Jeff, thank you very much for this recommendation and telling me that Loretta has passed, and also providing the links. I appreciate you. Thank you. And be safe down there. I don't know where the hell you're going to be, but be safe. All right. So Loretta Lynn, he's given us two songs, and we'll do a back-to-back, Coal Miner's Daughter and Fist City. Now, I don't know if these are his personal favorites or if it was just based on his researching that, you know, these are probably the least likely to get blocked. So I appreciate that as well, Jeff. All right, so let's do this, y'all. Let's take a look at the Coal Miner's Daughter, Loretta Lynn, back to back, and then we'll dig into her life a little bit on the back end. So, starting with Coal Miner's Daughter, Loretta Lynn. Let's get it.
Poor man's dollar. My daddy worked all night in the van near coal mines, all day long in a field of hoeing corn. Mommy rocked the babies at night and read the Bible by the coal oil light, and everything would start all over come break of morn. Daddy loved and raised somewhere. Yeah, I'm proud to be a coal miner's daughter. I remember
Fist City.
You've been making your brags around town that you've been loving my man. But the man I love, when he picks up trash, he puts it in a garbage can. And that's what you look like to me, and what I see's a pity. You better close your face and stay out of my way if you don't wanna go to Fist City. You better detour around my town, 'cause I'll grab you by the hair of the head and I'll lift you off of the ground. I'm not a saying my baby's a saint, 'cause he ain't, and that he won't pat around with a kitty. I'm here to tell you, gotta lay off of my man if you don't wanna go to Fist City. Come on and tell me what you told my friends, if you think you're brave enough. And I'll show you what a real woman is, since you think you're hot stuff. You'll bite off more than you can chew if you get too cute or witty. You better move your feet if you don't want to eat a meal that's called Fist City. If you don't want to go to Fist City, you better detour around my town, 'cause I'll grab you by the hair of the head and I'll lift you off of the ground. I'm not a sin, my baby's a saint, 'cause he ain't, and that he won't pat around with a kitty. I'm here to tell you, gotta lay off of my man if you don't want to go to Fist City. I'm here to tell you, gotta lay off of my man if you don't want to.
Icon. What a legend. Loretta Lynn. Yo, man. It's examples like these that makes me really appreciate the people who have gone before and paved the way, you know, paid their dues, and have brought all of this fantastic music to us. You can tell that she is singing about real subject matter, can't you? You can tell that this is a page out of her life experience, and she is putting it into song. And how great is it that back then we had these artists, man, it was just them, their guitar and their voice, and that was it. No damn auto-tune, nothing else except them. There was just the magic elixir of just the artist and their voice and their instrument, if they're playing one. And that's all you needed, you know what I'm saying? Fantastic times, fantastic moment in time. And she was a part of that time. And even though I was not raised on country music or what have you, you know, there are icons out there in the genre that you that they're a part of your life. You know, she was a part of my life. As long as I've been alive, I know of Loretta Lynn. Now, at the same time, as soon as you say to me, Wayne, Loretta Lynn, go, the only thing that I can come up with was Coal Miner's Daughter. That's really all I know about Loretta Lynn. I know she's the older sister of, oh my gosh, the lady with the super, super long hair. Make my brown eyes blue. Yeah, you know who I'm talking about. She's the Crystal Gale. She's the older singer, she's the elder sister of Crystal Gale. And so, and I know that there was a movie made about Loretta Lynn. Sissy Spacek, is it? The lady that played Carrie. I don't think I've seen the movie, but I have that image in my mind. So I know a little bit about Loretta Lynn, but not a whole lot. But what I do know is that she was ever present in my life, an ever present part of my life, despite the genre or whatever the case is. And that leads me to another very important point. Going forward with this channel, if you guys don't know, this channel is basically now a tribute channel. And it's a tribute channel not just to classic rock, But to the artists who have been a very, very strong presence, their contributions have crossed over and they have influenced our very fabric, the fabric of our social presence and our culture. And so it's more important to show respect to all of the artists across the board who have had that kind of influence. So, you know, don't be surprised to see Loretta Lynn today, or someone in the classic rock genre, or someone who might have been in blues, or whatever the case is, because now this channel is basically just a tribute to those great icons and pioneers who have influenced us so much. If I was still doing classic rock reactions, per se, and I was still doing it on the full, then I would stick to that structure, you know? But that's what it is going forward, just so you know, because I know some people, they've been asking me, hey, I saw that you did a tribute to Olivia Newton-John. She's not classic rock. So just so you know, I guess I got to go on the record and kind of explain it. And it makes sense, you know what I mean? You know, a lady like this with her influence and all that she's given us definitely deserves recognition and a tribute despite the genre specific that she's a part of. So that's how I feel about that, man. Let's do this. Man, you should see the length of her wiki bio and just the list of her accomplishments and her awards and all of the charity work and donations. Yo, man, okay, let's do this, y'all. With tribute reactions, I really, really keep the reading down to a minimum. So let's introduce the lady, especially for people who have just joined the channel and they're kind of getting an idea of my structure. And then I want to go into her passing and her health leading up to her passing. I guess she was on the slow decline. So let's start with introducing the lady, Loretta Lynn. Loretta Lynn, April 14th, 1932 to October 4th, 2022, was an American singer-songwriter. In a career which spanned six decades in country music, Lynn released multiple gold albums. She had hits such as You Ain't Woman Enough to Take My Man, Don't Come A-Drinkin' with Lovin' on Your Mind, Hair's on the Way, One's on the Way, sorry, Fist City, and Coal Miner's Daughter. In 1980, the film Coal Miner's Daughter was made based on her life. Right. That was a long time ago, damn. Lynn received many awards and other accolades for her groundbreaking role in country music, including awards from both the Country Music Association and Academy of Country Music as a duet partner and an individual artist. I believe she was a duet partner with... he's passed as well. Conway Twitty, is it not? Okay, she might have been... she's been around a long time, so she's probably had a lot of duets. She was nominated 18 times for a Grammy Award and won 3 times. As of 2022, Lynn was the most awarded female country recording artist and the only female ACM artist of the decade in the 1970s. Lynn scored 24 number one hit singles and 11 number one albums. She ended 57 years of touring on the road after she suffered a stroke in 2017 and then broke her hip in 2018. It's sad when we get older, isn't it? And you know, we start to suffer all of these different things. It's awful. But look at that, man. Well into her 80s, she was still on the road, still performing. You talk about having a zest and a passion for life and your craft. Okay, let's scroll down. Yeah, man, there's just so much bio information. It's unbelievable. Health and death. Over the years, Lynn suffered from various health concerns, including pneumonia on multiple occasions and a broken arm after a fall at home. In 2010, Lynn missed a tribute to her from other women of country music due to undergoing knee surgery. In May of 2017, Lynn had a stroke at her home in Hurricane Mills. She was taken to a Nashville hospital and as a result had to cancel all of her upcoming tour dates. The release of her album, Wouldn't It Be Great, was delayed until 2018. And still producing albums, wow. On January 1st, 2018, Lynn fell and broke her hip. Lynn died in her sleep at her home in Hurricane Mills, October 4, 2022, at the age of 90. No cause of death was immediately given. Wow. Well, rest in peace, Loretta Lynn. And sadly, she suffered a little bit, and she was in some pain as she got a little bit older, which is sad, but I guess it's just a part of the process of life and getting older. But yeah, even throughout all of that, she still had that zest to perform, that zest to be a part of the country music scene and to embrace her love for music. Fantastic, man. What a great, great life. What a great odyssey. So that is it, y'all. That is our look at Loretta Lynn, the great Loretta Lynn. Always been a part of my life, you know, and you know, with these great icons passing, you know, we really, really have to enjoy them while we've got them, let me tell you. And I'm not even going to get into that whole rule of threes thing that you know, I talk about, because if you talk about something, you will bring it into existence. So I'm not even going to even put a little bit of a lot of attention on it. But yeah, man, you know, what else can I say about Loretta Lynn? There was something else I was going to say. I believe that she was married only once. And I, just like Dolly Parton, I think she was married to the same person until he passed. And I forgot her husband's name, but I know he passed in the 90s, I believe it was. So yeah, man, you know, she's had a really, really fantastic life, and she has really been a great example of someone who's always carried herself very, very well. I've never heard anything negative about Loretta Lynn in media and anything like that. No scandals as far as I know. And I think that she lived the way she sang, lived the way she told a story and song, you know, and all the way through, I think that she's just been a great, great example and a class act, man. So hats off to you, Loretta Lynn. So, yeah, I just made a quick note here, guys. I want to give a shout out and a little bit of light and best wishes to Kel and Rich. I don't know if you guys know of Kel and Rich, but they've got a really, really excellent music channel, and they have been absent for more than a year, and they were having some struggles, and they were having some issues and some health challenges, but now they're back. I don't know to what extent that they're back, if they're going to be diving really, really deep into the reaction process, you know, full time as they were before. But if they are going to be picking up that kind of steam, this is what I recommend that you do. Go over to them and say, hey, Wayne sent us. And what you're going to do is you're going to ask them if they could perhaps do a Led Zeppelin discography, just like I've done. And I believe that maybe there's one or two people who are doing the same thing, but ask him to do a Led Zeppelin discography. Start from the very, very beginning. I know Rich is familiar with Led Zeppelin, but I don't believe his wife, Kel, really has a lot of exposure with the odd couple of reactions that they've done. So to have those two cover the entire Led Zeppelin discography, or whatever other band that you might feel that they might really, really like, I think would be a really, really nice treat to see. So, you know, I don't think that they'd have a problem doing that at all. So let them know that Soul Train Bro sent you over, okay? Welcome back, Kel and Rich. You were very, very well missed. So, y'all, going back to Loretta Lynn, great icon, a wonderful lady, and a really, really excellent example of a fantastic life lived. and she has been such a masterful credit to the entire industry, just by the way she lived, her elegance, her grace, her beauty, and everything else that she brought to it. So a fantastic icon that's going to be sorely missed. Hats off to you, Loretta Lynn. All right, y'all, have a good one. Take care, and hopefully you're not going to see me anytime soon. Peace out.